I've never eaten some of those raw. And I never will again. Hello dear Bums and Bumblets. Bumschef is back today bringing you myself without having a single clue about what I'm doing. I've seen lamacun, those wraps made by Arabian people, Turkish, Iranian, Lebanon, and all eat those lamacun. It's like a pizza but wrapped up, and this is the biggest challenge. How do you make a yeast pizza that's not cross and hard but all sloppy so you can wrap it up? I have not a clue. I'm doing this without looking things up, just guessing most of the time. First guess is they do a total normal yeast dough but add a lot of oil. I guess, so I've done this. Let's take a look. Looks normal. Now I'm gonna roll it to plate like round as pizza. This should be enough for a really big round wrap or lamacun. Maybe even less, because what I do know is they are fairly thin. So I'm trying. Okay, things are totally not like planned, but this had to happen at some point, but not right at the start. The added oil makes it very sticky, and of course I could add more flour, but then the effect of the oil to make it soft gets away as well. So what do I do? I don't have much of a choice. I add more flour and hope for the best. Okay, this is the result. That's not really round, but round enough. So now that I have a general feeling about how to handle those, I'm gonna start with the sauce. I could make things complicated and cook a special tomato sauce, but I'm using instant tomato sauce. What I do cook by myself is the meat. I add some meat. Plain minced meat, pork and beef. Of course some oil. And I'm becoming a feeling. I think the oven should be totally heat up by now before I shove them into the oven. This is why I heat the oven up on maximum heat right now. And when I put in the wraps, I think I should only leave them about 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes in it. Okay, it's the second one. What I could achieve is they being really thin, almost transparent. Oops, trying to run away. This is good, almost transparent, really, really thin, but now they are so fragile, they are breaking and cutting so easily. Really be careful. What's really stupid is that I only have two plates. I can make only two at the same time. So while the oven is catching up heat and the minced meat is doing the same, we can cut some vegetables that will be added in the final wrap. We don't want this green yellow part, it's only bitter, totally not enjoyable. So we remove it with our bare hands because this is the best tool. Okay, the meat needs the sauce. I reduce the heat, but there is too much water in this sauce. So we need to reduce it by letting it cook for 15 to 20 minutes, I guess. Okay, this is part one, the cold ingredients. And what follows after the cold ingredients? The sauce. Therefore, I've taken Greek yogurt. Greek because it's really fat and we want fat. And I will add only two more ingredients. One is lost, the garlic, and the other is isot. Or isot or iset. It's a dried bell pepper, chili, salt mix from Arabia. Okay, now I have to admit I'm a bit proud. I'm actually written down in the Guinness Book of World Records as the owner of world's worst garlic press. And mixing everything up. Number two is ready. This is the bowl. We had the dough inside and we fill in the sauce now because we need the pan. Okay, perfect. The oven has maximum heat. The sauce is ready. Now we add the sauce to the large wraps and put them in the oven and hope for the best that they come out soft and wrappable and not hard and cross. That's enough. It could be even thinner, but the meat doesn't allow this. Okay, into the oven. Now we cut the ingredients that need to be heated up. First, I have celery. I don't know if they originally are in Lamachun, but I don't care. This is the bummification of this dish and I will add celery that will be fried in the pan. Some fresh oil. And the second hot ingredients will be eggplants and they will be cut in slices, thin slices, and I will grill them with my old reliable grill pan. This actually does not need any oil. If you take a look, as I said, 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, maybe even 2 minutes is too much. It's hot as fuck, but as you can see, it's soft. It really became soft. So I guess my guess was right. Just add more oil to the yeast dough. the salary really needs is time, a lot of time, but we have a lot of eggplants to fry, so this is okay. I'm now twisting them with my bare hands, because what did we learn? It's a pistol. They need even longer. But that's totally fine, because we have more wraps to roll. I think I'm getting a grip on this, because this one is much better and it was rattling much faster. And as always, rule number one when frying something:
twist it only once.
And we add the sauce another time. Slightly plan change. I don't have any sauce left, but that's okay. Now we have a vegetarian lunch. This is ready. And the eggplants are ready as well, so we get them out. And add the remaining ones. Okay, let's take a look in the oven. And the test. Yes, soft. And the vegetarian one. Soft as well. I'm really glad that all this worked out. Okay, and now we clean up all this mess we made. Okay, mission accomplished. At least it looks good and looks original, but in the end it's all very bummified, bum-chefified, whatever. And last thing is, we give it a taste. Where to start? And a big chunk of and now the magic moment, we try to wrap things up. Okay. Okay, as you can see, we have a failure here. What now? So it has become a bit too soft, as it seems. I'm gonna show you what we do with it. Simple, we act like a bum because we are bums. Tastes really good. You just have to be a bum while eating it. And remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.